Hi, I'm Lisa Prather, and welcome to The Voice of Health with our host, Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice, where lives are changed every day through the natural approach to healthcare.
Well, today we're talking about quitting smoking. It's a marathon, not a sprint. Mm-hmm. And Dr. Prather, why do a show on smoking, and why call it a marathon and not a sprint?
No, good question. Smoking, of course, is bad for you.
Mm-hmm.
And for those who disagree with that, they're just trying to pretend that they can justify their smoking. But smoking just is one of the major aspects of longevity. You know, if the more you smoke, the younger that you start, the more likely you are to have problems from smoking, cancer, cardiovascular disease, stroke, all sorts of health problems develop from cigarette smoking.
Mm-hmm.
So quitting is just sort of a given.
Mm-hmm.
That's not something you should be doing. The other thing is that, you know, looking at it as a marathon instead of a sprint, you know, one of the major things is that people, well, you know, I've tried to quit smoking.
Mm-hmm.
But that's not really an excuse. The average person tries at least three times before they quit. So
they've tried three times, and then...
And then they finally make it.
Yeah.
So, and that's the average.
Okay.
So, you know, it's you've got to give yourself a little bit of grace here.
Mm-hmm.
You're talking about something that's very difficult to do.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, so looking at it, and even if you have quit smoking, one of the major problems that people have is they start up again.
Mm-hmm.
When some stressful situation or something happens, and I've known people who had quit for 10 years and then started again.
Mm-hmm.
So it's the old thing of, you know, once you've kind of become addicted and you have that tendency, you need to be looking at it as a lifetime type of a thing. Not get discouraged. Give yourself grace and keep trying.
Right. And if you fall, get right back up.
If you fall, get right back up.
Yeah. Right. So people that smoke, do they want to quit smoking?
That's the very interesting thing. They've done surveys on people who smoke, and 75% of the people want to quit.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
So it's not something that people are like, wow, you know, I really enjoy smoking.
Mm-hmm.
It's 75% of the people, 25% say, no, I really don't want to quit, but I think they really do. They just don't want to be, you know, fail.
Mm-hmm.
But 75% of the people say, yes, I would really, really like to quit.
And why is it so hard to quit smoking?
Well, the nicotine, of course, is naturally in tobacco. But the modern cigarette has only like 2% actual tobacco in it.
Just 2%?
2%.
What else is in there, or should I ask?
Yeah. The rest of it is, most of it is actually ground up cardboard.
Hmm.
And which they then dip into 70,000 chemicals.
Wow. Why?
It's a mixture that the tobacco industry put together to make it as addictive as possible.
Hmm.
So we have a product that is very, very bad for you. And these chemicals put out, you know, that they actually dip it into. It's not only tobacco was bad for you, but a cigarette is a manufactured product. It's not really natural. You can get natural tobacco cigarettes, and they are not as addictive.
Mm, okay.
So, you know, American Spirit, some of the others, mm-hmm. Don't have the same addictive. And even though that they are not good for you, they are not as bad for you as actual cigarettes. Not that I'm encouraging people, you know, to smoke, mm-hmm. even regular cigarettes. But the cigarette industry has gone out of their way to design a product that is very, very cheap to make. extremely, extremely high profits. And it is probably the hardest thing to quit because it's designed to actually have that. And this was something that there was a whistleblower. Someone within the industry said, hey, you know, this is the reality of what we're doing. That's why they had the whole lawsuit against the, you know, the federal government said, hey, you know, you wanted to keep your product secret on how it was doing it. You paid off a lot of lawmakers who allowed you to do that for a long period of time. And then you got scientists to figure out how to make this product as addictive as possible. Mm-hmm. And in the meantime, it, you know, these chemicals and these toxins were going into people and causing huge amounts of health issues beyond what would be normal and natural. Mm-hmm. And you did this all because of greed and profit at the expense of everyone else. And this was wrong. So they had huge settlements that they had to pay out. It was all proven in courts of law on what actually occurred. And, you know, definitely I would say, I mean, you know, the people who were involved in that, I think should have gone to jail. Mm-hmm. They were killing people, mm-hmm. Large numbers of people, and without any, you know, without really any consequences. Yeah. So, you know, it's
amazing what greed can do.
It is. And it was something that is, if the more you find out about it, really the more shocking the cigarette industry actually is, mm-hmm. and their callousness. Mm.
So how addictive are cigarettes?
It is, as they've done the research, it's the most addictive product out there. So if you are struggling with trying to work off of the cigarettes, it's understandable. Mm-hmm. You know, so people need help. Mm-hmm. There are people who can go out there and just quit. My hat is off to them.
The cold turkey.
Yeah, cold turkey, mm-hmm. and going ahead. But understand that there have been, you know, there is a design behind how they made those, and there's a chemical dependence and all sorts of different types of things play into how this works.
Well, what happens with addictions?
Well, when you're talking about the physiology, I'm not going to bore people with the chemistry and mm-hmm. everything that occurs on that.
There's probably some listeners that you wouldn't bore.
Okay. But there's physiological changes that occur. So the body becomes used to it. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, it requires it. Not only is there a change in, you know, your physiology of your body that asks for it, but there's also a brain change. Mm-hmm. So the areas that are well known to create addictions become more active, mm-hmm. and they override more of our choice areas, you know, the frontal lobe. So there is actually a brain change that occurs, and the body for a period of time does not work well without the cigarettes. I mean, obviously it's causing disease, you know, mm-hmm. as you're going through it, but there is changes that occur, and people will go, well, you know, I'm just not thinking right without the cigarettes, you know, I'm jittery, you know, look, my hands are shaking. Mm-hmm. You know, there's other different types of addictions that, you know, people try to start to crave to help to satisfy that. And yes, there are physiological changes that go on. And, you know, the whole thing is that there are ways to get around those.
Mm-hmm. So why do people start smoking?
That's a big thing that the cigarette industry actually tried to figure out.
Well, they can't advertise. Remember, they used to advertise on TV, television, billboards.
There are other ways that they do advertise. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they have not reduced their advertising spending.
Okay.
So there was restrictions on how they could advertise, but believe me, they still advertise. Mm-hmm. And the biggest thing that they found is they have to get people young.
Yeah, and that's increased, hasn't it, the younger population?
Yes, younger population is, you know, there for a while it had decreased quite a bit, but it is, in, especially in certain populations, it is increasing quite a bit. And they know how to target young people. Mm-hmm. And what is that sets them into going ahead and starting smoking. And there is a psychological profile on who will start smoking and how to appeal to them.
Wow.
And they have spent huge amounts of money to figure out the psychology on that and get young people hooked.
Yeah. Do you remember the Marlboro Man?
Yes.
I remember that. In Detroit, there's this huge billboard of the Marlboro Man.
Right, yeah. Right.
But you don't see that, you know.
It's definitely, you know, as they were hitting the youth, it was those who were feeling disassociated, mm-hmm. people who feel, kids who felt inadequate.
Aw. Uh-huh. They would target.
That's the most vulnerable.
Wow. Well, I don't want to answer for that. I want to be them.
Yeah.
Okay. When we come back, let's talk about treatment for quitting smoking.
You can win a free 60-minute massage in a relaxing spa at the Prather Practice. Each month, we have a drawing to give away a free massage to one of our lucky Facebook and Twitter fans. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. This is The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather. The Voice of Health Wellness Tip with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice.
The three tests, Dr. Prather, that you suggest everyone have every year, you know, to give a complete picture of health is the Prather Profile Blood Analysis, the GI Effects Stool Kit, and the hair analysis. And what does the hair analysis reveal about a person's health?
Well, one of the most important things that we're looking on a hair analysis is the possibility of heavy metal toxicity. That can cause a huge variety of diseases and symptoms that can actually occur. Any type of autoimmune disease could begin with a heavy metal toxicity, or any type of neurological conditions, MS, ALS, a lot of those types of diseases can be kicked off by heavy metal toxicity, including a whole host of symptoms that would be hard to explain any other way. The other things that show up with the hair analysis is the balance of the minerals. It can play a huge effect on the entire system. Now, when plants actually grow, they can actually make the fatty acids, the vitamins, the amino acids, but the minerals have to come from the ground. So if the minerals aren't there, they can't make them. So the most common deficiencies that can occur in nutritional health of an individual is mineral deficiencies or mineral imbalances. And the hair analysis is the best way to actually show up those changes that can occur.
Well, how does the hair analysis help find the root cause of health issues? And no pun intended there.
When you're actually trying to discover what's going on in an individual, so many things can actually result with a mineral imbalance or a heavy metal toxicity that behooves us to actually do that particular test. And that's one reason that I recommend it be done at least once a year. And if there's any type of important type of disease process going on or unexplained symptoms, checking on the hair analysis really can show a tremendous amount and cause reveal the underlying problem.
Schedule your appointment at the Prather Practice, 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. Or learn more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. The Prather Practice, restoring hope.
I feel good. I knew that I would not.
You're listening to The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice. the most comprehensive wellness center in the Midwest.
Quitting smoking, that's what we're talking about today. It's a marathon, not a sprint. And that might not encourage some people. I mean,
well, you know, but the reality, I want people to, well, you know, I tried. And then the main reason why haven't you, you know, when you ask the question, well, you want to quit, 75% of the people do. Why didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I tried.
Yeah.
I tried twice.
And you said the average is three times.
Yeah.
It takes three times.
Yeah, because you learn different strategies as you go along. And that's the whole thing, is it's not just one thing on quitting smoking. You've got several different aspects on that.
Mm-hmm.
And having awareness of those aspects, and then, you know, what is the triggers that actually kick you off on smoking? That's
right.
One of the main things.
Right.
So, you know, having a good understanding of that really helps.
So how does the Prather practice help with quitting smoking?
Well, first off, we understand the difficulty.
Mm-hmm.
And the other thing is that we have a lot of different ways. And when you're talking about quitting smoking, there's a lot of aspects that are involved in that. Why is it that people, and you need to discover on why the person starts up with the smoking again.
Mm-hmm.
And there can be many different reasons on that. You know, it could be the addiction centers in the brain.
Mm-hmm.
Could be one of the things that is kicking off the smoking. Again, you know, the anxiety. You know, the person becomes too anxious to function. Clear thinking goes by the wayside. Food cravings start to kick in. It could be that whenever they smell cigarette smoke, they have this uncontrollable urge to start smoking.
Mm-hmm.
And there's ways to approach that. So each of these different types of aspects of quitting smoking have different types of treatments to help it. So we don't have just one means of working with quitting smoking. We have many different types of means. And then helping people to understand, get those strategies together. We do have life coach. We have nutritional different types of things that go along with that. So as we can put together a total package to find out what's going to help that person. And then also an understanding to educate them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, education, knowledge is very important. If people had the knowledge of what to do, one, they wouldn't start smoking. And then two, the success rate goes way up if someone has coaching on how to quit smoking and provide the different types of aspects that can help them through that.
Mm-hmm. Makes sense.
Sure.
So does acupuncture help?
Acupuncture is marvelous. There are certain protocols and certain points that are miraculous in helping with acupuncture. Acupuncture is not necessarily, as we're talking about this,
mm-hmm.
you know, people are looking for magic bullets and different, but everybody has a different magic bullet.
Mm-hmm.
What acupuncture really helps with is the anxiety aspect of quitting smoking. So it's not a panacea.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it doesn't work for everybody, but for those people that anxiety after quitting smoking,
mm-hmm.
you know, where you get the shakes, things like that, acupuncture, as you use that, especially as you hit some of the nerve points, there's a relaxation that occurs. Matter of fact, I have people coming in for acupuncture. I have an executive who, you know, this is much better than taking anxiety drugs. Because
mm-hmm.
he's underneath a lot of pressure. He doesn't smoke, but he, you know, he can sleep, everything like that. So he comes in about once every 2 weeks and gets some acupuncture so that he has a relaxation. I had people who were studying for their
bar exam.
Bar exam and accounting board, and they were taking different types of Ritalin, Concerta, just for concentration, and they found that the acupuncture did much better, and it does. So if anxiety is probably the main thing that's keeping you from quitting smoking, acupuncture is extremely effective.
Mm-hmm.
And again, it's a matter of the will. Acupuncture doesn't make you stop.
Right.
But it helps especially with the anxiety because there are different types of endorphin and Kefalon You get a natural opiates that increase in the body. Oxytocin really is released quite at a high level because you're hitting certain points. There is a tremendous amount of physiological changes with acupuncture. And so with the anxiety portion of quitting smoking, acupuncture is just by hands down one of the very best ways of approaching that.
It's amazing, too, how many people fall asleep when doing acupuncture.
Yes. It's like, wow. I've had so many people said, I got better, my relaxation rate was just even higher than a massage. And a massage is another way to work with the anxiety portion. So you combine a massage and an acupuncture treatment together.
Not at the same time, though.
Well, yeah, I mean, one after the other. I mean, you're just, you know, you don't even care about cigarettes at that point.
Well, let's talk about auricular therapy.
Auricular therapy. Now, we talked about that there were brain changes that occurred, mm-hmm. with especially on addiction points in the brain. And that is where auricular therapy really comes in. So if that's one of the major problems, is that the addiction, the areas of the brain are stimulated and you are dependent upon those, then auricular will change those brain waves. One of the nice things that they've done on research on auricular is they know what areas of your brain are involved with the addiction of cigarette smoking. Mm-hmm. And you can do auricular, and those brainwave changes will occur. So it's a very proven therapy. Auricular therapy is probably one of the most proven therapies in the entire world. And it will change the brain patterns for any addiction. Mm-hmm. Not just cigarette smoking, but any addiction that you have, auricular therapy is the way to go.
If you have a brain, it helps.
If you have a brain, it helps. So getting the brain waves, getting the brain balanced out, you can approach that through auricular therapy. The ears are the keyboards, as I like to say, to the brain.
Yeah, and that auricular means ear, and you're hitting ear points that correspond to the brain.
And what we're doing is using microcurrent, mm-hmm. points, and it's been, there are different settings for different points on the ears, so there's a whole science behind that. And for addiction. Now, the other thing about cigarette smoking is there are different kinds of addictions. Mm-hmm. So there is the addiction of the chemicals, which stimulates certain portions of the brain, but there's also an oral reflex. Mm-hmm. That is a different portion of the brain, and having that something in your mouth, mm-hmm. is sometimes the addiction that people have with cigarettes or doing something with your hands.
Right.
I've had people that, you know, it was more of the hand-mouth type of thing, more than anything else that was really keeping them smoking. So there was one, auricular is excellent for that. Mm-hmm. And then also finding substitutes. Celery is an amazing type of thing. So just carrying around a pack of celery.
Oh, celery?
Yeah. Uh-huh. And then you can sit there and you've got something to do with your hands and you got the oral reflex, mm-hmm. too.
Right. And you have to leave the building.
Yeah. And that's, you see, a lot of people gain weight when they quit smoking. Mm-hmm. And the reason that they gain weight is the oral hand. They need to do something with their hands and their mouth. And so they don't have cigarettes anymore, so they start to do food.
Right.
So having a substitute, celery actually has negative calories, so people eat a lot of celery.
Uh-huh. Well, it's interesting because I remember one young man coming in for smoking cessation, and he just did the auricular 6 treatments. We start with a 6 protocol on the auricular therapy, and he was able to quit after the 6. And this was a guy that was living with people. All of them smoked but him.
Sure.
And he was able to, he came in a year later for another issue, and he still wasn't smoking and in the same, you know, situation. And
I even had one guy who was one treatment. Mm-hmm. And he said, I'd tried everything. I'd done hypnosis. But it was the brainwave was the major type of thing. And then realizing the different aspects on that. Mm-hmm. See, auricular isn't the answer for everybody.
Right. And not everybody that's going to come in is going to be one treatment.
Right. Mm-hmm. That was the area that was really keeping them from quitting smoking.
Well, let's talk about homeopathics.
Sure.
Are they helpful?
Another aspect of that's very interesting, if you are allergic to cigarette smoke, mm-hmm. you become addicted. And people have it's a very interesting type of aspect. People who, like if you have an allergy to chocolate, people crave chocolate. Mm-hmm. So there can be, you can be allergic to the cigarettes. And that's why, like this one gentleman, every time that he smelled cigarette smoke, he had to smoke. Mm-hmm. And it was actually an allergic reaction that he was having. And the body was not processing that correctly.
Uh-huh.
So homeopathy was the inspiration for allergy shots.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So what they found is that you can give homeopathics if you have for a very small amount of that, and then you get over the allergies. So if you are allergic to cigarettes and cigarette smoke, you can take homeopathics, and it's like taking an allergy shot for the cigarettes and the cigarette smoke.
Interesting.
And that has been very effective on those people. I had a gentleman came in, and he said, you know, I do fine. I really don't crave it, but as soon as I get around where I smell cigarette smoke, I got to have it. Hmm. And, you know, as we would do allergy testing, he showed up that he was very allergic to the cigarette smoke, and so he was kicking off a reaction on that. So we gave him homeopathics. It was like taking an allergy shot.
Mm-hmm.
And voila.
Without the shot.
And, uh-huh. Well, we can do shots, you know, if it's really bad. But
yeah.
The delivery system, we can do it in a lot of different types of ways. But that's another way of approaching it. And again, we're looking at the whole system and how we can get everything under control.
Okay. Well, we're talking today about quitting smoking. It's a marathon, not a sprint.
Listen to the Voice of Health Radio on your smartphone or tablet on all of the top radio apps available. TuneIn Radio, Stitcher, and iHeartRadio. You can find these apps and more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. This is The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather. Laughter is the best medicine.
He's a good doctor, I think, you know. I told him I get heartburn sometimes, so he goes and gets me a list of things that cause heartburn. I'm looking at the list and I'm like, I already know this. I know how to get it. That's like going into the hospital with a cannonball wound and they show you a list. Here's how you get cannonball wounds. I have a cannonball wound. It's gaping. Do you have a tube of cannonball wound ointment?
A special message from the DTS Weight Loss Center at the Prather Practice.
Are you tired of making the same weight loss resolution only to end up right back where you started? Let the professionals at DTS Weight Loss Center take all the frustration out of dieting. Our nutritionists and wellness coaches know what works for every body type and can develop a plan specific to your needs throughout your medically supervised program. Make the change by visiting us online at DTSweightLossCenter.com. Dedicate. Transform. Succeed.
When you call the Prather Practice to schedule your appointment at our DTS Weight Loss Center, mention the Voice of Health radio show and you'll receive a free initial consultation plus a free body composition analysis. 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. The DTS Weight Loss Center at the Prather Practice. Dedicate, transform, succeed.
Doctor, doctor, give me the news. I got a package loving you. No pills gonna kill my head.
I'm Lisa Prather, and you're listening to The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather of The Prather Practice, where we get to the root cause of your health issue.
We're talking today about quitting smoking. It's a marathon, not a sprint. Dr. Prather, we're talking about the different treatments that we provide at the Prather Practice. and how individualized they are, mm-hmm. depending on what type of addiction they have, you know, what is it based on, anxiety. So we talked about, you know, how acupuncture can help, auricular therapy, homeopathics, mm-hmm. right, especially if someone's allergic. And that's an interesting, you know, thought, you know, alcoholics that are allergic sure. to alcohol.
Well, one of the things is I did testing on myself, and I'm allergic to tobacco. Mm-hmm. So if I started smoking, it would be very difficult for me to get off of it because it would actually create an allergy. So I know personally that I'm allergic to cigarette smoke. If people come in and I smell cigarette smoke, I start sneezing.
Yeah, and what is it about smokers don't smell? They don't seem to smell smoke on themselves.
There is a change in the olfactory and how the body responds to things. So, you know, that's actually also a sign that you probably are allergic to it.
Really? If you can't smell. Interesting. Well, let's talk about the detoxification process.
Well, one of the things is we talked about all the different chemicals that are involved in cigarettes. And they create a toxicity in the body that is really, really horrible. So one of the things that occurs is as people start to stop smoking, there's a detoxification that starts to take place. And the body doesn't handle it very well. Mm-hmm. So people feel awful. Mm-hmm. So if toxicity is one of the major issues, a lot of the you know, and then they start smoking again, they say, well, I feel so much better when I smoke. Mm-hmm. Well, it's because the body's detoxing and you don't feel very good during the detox. So there are different ways, there are different herbals, different methods of getting the toxins out of the system. And then once the person is detoxed and helping them to realize what are the symptoms that are involved with that, once they're detoxed, they feel better than they have for years. Mm-hmm. But you oftentimes need to detox the patient to be able to get them off the cigarettes, because what they think is actually an addiction is, and feeling bad after they quit smoking, is really a detoxification process that they really need to go through to keep them from getting cancer, because mm-hmm. it's the toxins that kick off the cancer. So, you know, if you're having issues, it means that, and you're quitting smoking and you feel sick, guess what? You really better quit smoking.
Well, you have to do the detoxification because you're smoking toxic cardboard.
Right.
Dipped in, you said, 70,000 chemicals.
Right.
And you're paying money for that.
And you're paying money for it. You're paying money to get yourself killed.
Now, my mom smoked growing up, and I remember she would send me on my bike with a little note, and I'd go pick up her Pall Malls. I think they were like 99 cents a pack. I have no idea how much cigarettes are now, but, you know, people could save money.
Yeah.
And they know that. So why is nutrition helpful?
When you smoke, you become nutritionally deficient in a lot of different types of areas. The smoke creates a tremendous number of free radical pathology, where there's a free electron that goes through and starts to damage different parts of the body. There's a increased need for B vitamins, vitamin C. Matter of fact, one of the most common things that kicks off like disc problems, you know, if you have a herniated disc in the neck or the back, cigarette smoking actually kicks those off. Mm. The reason is because it decreases the body's nutritional capabilities. So you become deficient in minerals, vitamins, which weaken the discs. Mm. And so then you get the herniations that occur quite you know, much easier.
Right.
So nutritional needs are also something that should be looked at. And one of the things that we have found is that once we get the nutrition working much better, people find it much easier to quit smoking cigarettes. So nutritional deficiencies are also another area to look at and can play a very big role and a big help. Also, diet, of course, needs to be looked at, especially as you're quitting smoking.
Right.
So you don't put on weight and just substitute one addiction for another.
Well, and that's interesting how it can destroy, you know, the disc. The disc are so, they need the nutrition.
Yes. You know, when you're talking about back problems, things like that, nutrition plays a very big role in that.
Mm-hmm. Well, what are the health benefits of quitting?
Well, you know, the any time that you, I mean, one of the big things is that people talk about is, you know, well, I've smoked for so many years, you know, is it really worth it for me to quit?
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Even within... even within a year of quitting smoking, the risk for cardiovascular disease and cancer decreased quite dramatically.
Wow.
So, you know, it's something that people notice that they can breathe easier, they're able to run farther, there's less coughing. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of immediate types of benefits for quitting smoking. Mm-hmm. But even then, you know, the longer that you go. Matter of fact, after 15 years of quitting smoking, the risk are about the same as someone who'd never smoked.
Well, that's encouraging.
Yes.
Mm-hmm, very
so
encouraging.
The body remakes itself every 7 years. So you can if you do things properly, you can really get a reversal of what's going on.
Yeah. Is it ever too late to quit?
It is never too late to quit.
Mm-hmm.
Even within a year and a half, even if you're 80 and you've been smoking all your life, mm-hmm. you can start to get some benefits on your health by quitting smoking that wouldn't be realized, you know, if you hadn't.
Well, and you've talked before, too, about the lack of oxygen it causes and why smokers are a little, their skin's a little more wrinkly and...
Sure.
Because of the lack of oxygen.
Yeah, the it's interesting, but there is damage that actually occurs every time that there's some cigarette smoke that you breathe in.
Mm, oh, well, let's talk about that. How harmful is secondhand smoke?
Secondhand smoke is not as bad as actually smoking, but you get about 60 to 70% of the harm mm-hmm. as if you were the smoker. If you were around somebody, especially in an enclosed area, you know, for the smoking, and that's one of the reasons that it's so harmful if you have children.
Mm-hmm.
That you know, if you're smoking around your kids in the car, in the house, apartment, whatever. That kid's getting the cigarette smoke, and that's the reason that oftentimes cigarette smoke becomes handed down because they're already addicted.
What about asthma? I mean, they're...
Oh, yeah. huge relationship to if your parents are smokers and you're a child, mm-hmm. you have three times the chance of developing asthma because your parents were smokers.
Wow.
So it's a very big problem, and one of the things is if, you know, pregnant.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, what effect does smoking have on pregnancy?
It's just as if the baby was smoking themselves.
Uh-huh.
You know, and the accumulation in the child, there are some studies that the child actually gets more of the effects of smoking than the mother does.
No.
And if the husband is smoking... then it also accumulates into the baby, too, because mm-hmm. they're exposed to some of the cigarette smoke, too. You're talking about lower birth weight, lower IQ, greater health issues, greater chance of ADHD, autism, all those different types of things increase quite dramatically if there is a smoker.
But it's encouraging. I think a lot of women that smoke quit when they get pregnant, you know, and... You know, that's not a plan. Like, that's not one of the things we're encouraging. Get pregnant so you quit smoking. But
it is a very big motivator because you think, sometimes we don't really necessarily say, well, it's just me.
Yeah.
You know, I can handle it well. Until you actually develop the problem, then it's like, why did I ever do this? But for, you know, when you start thinking about an innocent child and you're making the decisions for them, you have to make the right decisions.
Right. So what percentage of Americans smoke?
It's about 25% of Americans smoke at this time. Mm-hmm. One of the interesting things about that, though, is that there are more ex-smokers than there are smokers.
Oh, well, that's encouraging. Ex-smokers.
It is. Uh-huh. Yeah, so there are more people who have quit smoking than are actually smoking in the United States. Mm-hmm. So for those of you who are thinking about quitting, which is 75% of all smokers, want to, others have done it.
Yeah.
So be encouraged. Again, don't dwell on your failures. Mm-hmm. Be positive and keep going. It usually takes a few times to achieve it. Mm-hmm. And figuring out, what is it, the strategies that are actually going to work the best for you.
Okay, great. Okay, when we come back, more on quitting smoking.
Never miss an episode of The Voice of Health so that you can stay informed and empowered about your health. Get a podcast of our show automatically delivered to you every week by signing up for our show on iTunes. You can find that link on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. And don't forget, thevoiceofhealthradio.com has complete archives of all of our past episodes with an audio library of information to help you add more life to your years and more years to your life. This is The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather. The Voice of Health Wellness Tip with Dr. Robert Prather of the Prather Practice. What conditions can be helped with acupuncture?
The World Health Organization has actually done some definite research. Also, the National Institute of Health has done quite a bit of research on acupuncture with quite a bit of very strong evidence on what it works for and what it doesn't. If we take the digestive area, abdominal pain. I have a lot of people with severe abdominal pain. We can put the needles in. Oftentimes, there's immediate results. Constipation or diarrhea, mm-hmm. We can get some changes along those lines. The reflux has some very, very good results on that. Emotionally, I have a lot of people coming in for anxiety or depression. Mm. Insomnia. I have had patients who were, who even after the first treatment that night, they actually were able to sleep. One gal said, I haven't slept in a couple of days, put the needles in, she fell asleep on the table, and she said, wow. Infertility is a very common type of thing with a lot of research on.
We have a lot of people coming in.
Very high success rate mm-hmm. for that. Mm-hmm. But there are very definite points that affect fertility mm-hmm. that are very important to know. It's just not that you're going into an acupuncturist, he's randomly putting some needles in. You have to know where those points are, how they're affected, be able to evaluate them, see which ones are off, and how you can actually make an effect on the body to actually increase the fertility rate.
Have you had success with
getting
infertility?
Women pregnant?
Yeah.
I don't know if that's the best way to put it.
Right.
No, very definitely. We have a very high success rate with women with infertility. We have several proud moms who are also coming in for after the birth mm-hmm. Just to help to relax because it helped them so much, one, to get pregnant during the pregnancy, help to control the pain, nausea, all those types of things. And then afterwards, it's a very trying type of time and find that the acupuncture is very helpful at that time. But a very, very good success rate. Mm-hmm. I'm probably saying it's almost 80%.
Wow.
Which is really, really mm-hmm. good. Mm-hmm. So we're very proud of that and glad to help women in that struggle.
Find out if acupuncture is right for you. Schedule your appointment at the Prather Practice, 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. Or learn more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com. The Prather Practice, restoring hope. You're listening to The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather of The Prather Practice, where our mission is restoring hope to our patients.
Well, we're talking today about quitting smoking. It's a marathon, not a sprint. So, Dr. Prather, is there a safe level of tobacco smoke?
No.
Okay.
You know, it worried you there for a second because you were, you thought I was going to say yes, but no. The studies have shown that immediately as you smoke, there's a constriction of the blood vessels. There's some damage that occurs. There's damage to the lining of the lungs. Mm-hmm. There's an increase in free radical pathology. There are brain changes that start to occur. So, smoking is not something that you should do. Mm-hmm. A lot of young people sit there and think that they're immortal.
Yes.
And that there is, other people become addicted. I can quit whenever I want to. And that's just foolish. Mm-hmm. It just doesn't happen.
Well, I was thinking of, I think it's the American Cancer Association has the commercials of people that have had throat and,
right.
That... I have holes in their throat, and
I thought cigarette smoking would make me smoking cigarettes would make me sexy.
Yeah,
how does this look?
How does this look? Yeah, and I have worked with people on swallowing issues as an occupational therapist in the hospital that have had throat, missing parts of their tongue, and throat cancer, and
sure,
it's not pretty. It's not pretty.
It is not a pretty thing, and. And, it's even a little bit. That's also why, you shouldn't allow people to smoke around you either. Mm-hmm. That is not something that is, you wouldn't allow people to, throw chemicals into the water that you drink. You wouldn't allow people to spit on your food.
Unless you lived in Flint, Michigan.
Yeah.
Those poor people.
And then, so you don't allow people to mess with your air.
Mm-hmm.
It's not something that, and the more that people are aware of that you are creating an invasion onto people's space and you are doing me harm, mm-hmm. You can't do that.
Right. But there's, wonderful people. We're all created in God's image.
Oh.
Yeah, and we all have our different addictions. But this one will slowly kill you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes quickly.
Mm-hmm. Right. So if someone is or was a smoker, what steps should they take for their health?
Well, of course, quit if they are still smoking. If you have smoked, understand that there have been changes that have occurred in your body. And getting some good diagnostics and trying to help the body to reverse those aspects. Also avoiding some of the problems that occur with quitting smoking. One of the big ones is weight gain. So, have a plan on how you're going to watch your weight as you quit smoking. Mm-hmm. There are strategies on that. There are different means of working with that. So having some help. Everybody needs coaching. Matter of fact, one of the things that has been found is if you have a group who supports you,
mm-hmm.
Then your chances of success are much, much higher. In other words, the more people you tell that I'm going to quit smoking, the more you feel an accountability.
Accountability.
And if other people are also trying to quit smoking along with you or who have quit smoking, it's just like with alcoholics.
AA.
AA. Yeah. They found that a group and an accountability and a mentor and being a mentor helps other people to stay on the right path. So if you have quit smoking, encourage other people who are smoking to quit. Mm-hmm. Be a mentor to them because that also helps you to keep from going back into the smoking.
Mm.
I also find people who have quit smoking and have them encourage you. Tell your loved ones, especially those who are all for you to quit smoking, that you are going to quit smoking and for them to hold you accountable. And then also coming in for, a life coach, someone who can give you some valuable information along those lines. So, coming into an office like ours, Making sure that you get some good diagnostic testing, find out where some of the needs are. Also, evaluate whether you have an allergy. Do you have the areas of the brain that are addictive? Are they out of sync? And you need to have some work done along those lines. Some things to help to handle the anxieties, the food cravings, and, you know, the detoxification.
Yeah, is it, do you ever recommend someone going, you know, just switching? It's still smoking, but going to the American Spirit cigarette?
That is a very good step that we've been able to make for people. So one of the things is, you know, there's just no way, you know, I've tried quitting smoking and going cold turkey just doesn't work. But actually going to a natural cigarette for a period of time as they are working that down, worked quite well, and I've had some people who had come in and said, look, I've tried 12 times to quit smoking. Hasn't worked. I said, well, first off, let's, you know, we're going to kind of figure out what's going on, and then let's shift you to an American Spirit type of cigarette at this point. One of the things that occurred was that one guy was smoking 12 cigarettes a day, and he dropped from 12 down to 3.
Switching to the American Spirit.
To the American Spirit. And, you know, I asked him, well, what were some of the things that, you know, was helpful along those lines? And he says, well, it takes about five times as long to smoke one American cigarette as it does for, because real tobacco actually takes longer to burn than cardboard. So, one, it takes much longer.
Yeah.
So, he didn't smoke as many because of that. And then also there was nicotine was a very big thing, and the natural nicotine was actually more satisfying. So that really helped.
So it's
helped.
More of a natural product.
It's completely natural.
Okay.
So, matter of fact, they weren't in the big lawsuit because they didn't add anything to it.
Okay.
So it was real tobacco, and they figured that people knew what they were doing, so they weren't part of the lawsuit that the government put, against them, because they weren't tampering with it.
It's interesting, the American Spirit, does it have a Native American on the...
It does.
Yeah,
and
here in the United States, the Native Americans, are they the largest population of smokers?
They are. They have the highest percentage of smokers in the country. Also highest drug and alcohol addiction, too. So there's a lot of social types of issues that go along with that. But it is something that is a nice step along the way.
Right.
And then we found that people have a much easier time of actually quitting. So that was a strategy that I put together for him, and it was very effective.
Well, when so growing up, my mom smoked, and one day I just broke all her cigarettes, and she stopped smoking. So I think she got tired of me
breaking
all her cigarettes.
That's a good strategy. Again, it's
yeah. I tried it once, and I just didn't.
Oh.
I didn't like it. Good thing. Huh? Well, how can we keep young people from smoking?
Understanding one of the things that. It was interesting to read the psychological study of kids who smoke. Basically, it was disenfranchised young people who didn't really feel like they fit in, and they had low self-esteem. So one of the things that they really haven't done is that if you put out the information. And kids realize that smoking is a sign that you have low self-esteem, they won't do it. The reason that they smoke is they want to belong. And if you can identify yourself as a smoker and become instantly a part of a group. So finding other different types of means of getting together with people.
Right.
And the peer group is a very important type of thing. But if you can get the peers, your other peers, to help you to, if their impression is you smoke, you must have low self-esteem, kids don't smoke.
Right.
Because the last thing
you
they want to
cool.
do.
that
yeah,
they smoke.
Right. Mm-hmm. And the biggest thing that the pharmaceutical companies really tried to put out is, you're cool if you smoke, and it's just the opposite.
Right. Right. So we have a few seconds, Dr. Prather. Just want you to have time to close this topic.
Yes. And one of the things that I really encourage people is to get some structure function help, mm-hmm. where you're trying to balance out the body, because cigarette smoking causes a lot of health damage, and you need to get that reversed.
Good. Well, thank you, Dr. Prather. And for those out there that smoke, be encouraged. It's a marathon, not a sprint. And... Thank you again.
Thank you.
The Prather Practice is located at 8902 North Meridian Street on the north side of Indianapolis, just south of the I-465 loop. If we can help you to achieve better health, we'd love to hear from you. Connect with our office at 317-848-8048. That's 317-848-8048. Join us again here next week or anytime on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com for The Voice of Health with Dr. Robert Prather. Are you frustrated by not getting to the root cause of your health issue? Are you tired of not knowing why you're always fatigued? Are you wanting to say no to toxic drugs? Have you lost hope? Are you just tired of being sick and tired? At the Prather Practice, we want you to know that we have the answers for you. We offer the alternative to the disease care model. We are the drug-free model to health and wellness. At the Prather Practice, we look for the underlying cause of your health problem and not just the symptomatology. Through thorough diagnostics, we find your individual health blueprint for your treatment. Where the disease care model is symptom-based, the structure-function model we practice gets to the root of your health issue. The Prather Practice is the most comprehensive wellness center in the Midwest. Our integrative practice offers you the most treatment options to restore your health and your hope. Learn more about the Prather Practice by calling 317-848-8048 or learn more on our website at thevoiceofhealthradio.com.